Hemendra Rasik Lal Ghia versus Subodh Modi. Hemendra Rasik Lal Ghia versus Subodh Modi, 2008 Bombay. A full bench judgment of the Bombay High Court gave a beautiful judgment, and I recommend that you must read this judgment, Hemendra Ghia's judgment. It has settled all this confusion. And quoting R.V.E. Venkat Chalam's judgment of the Supreme Court, Bombay High Court and Hemendra Ghia's judgment held that it depends on the type of the objection, whether the court will decide immediately or the court will decide at the final stage will depend on the type of objection raised. And that is where these two categories of R.V.E. Venkat Chalam's were further confirmed by Hemendra Ghia's judgment in the Bombay High Court, that in case an objection raised is in respect of the admissibility of a document, then the court can decide it at a later final stage following Bipin Panchal. But if the objection is in respect of insufficiency of the stamping of a document, or if the objection is in respect of mode of proving of a document, then the court must take a call immediately. Then the court cannot delay it for further. As I said, that if the document or evidence which you are relying upon is insufficiently stamped and the objection is raised, the court has to decide it immediately. If the objection is in respect of mode of proving of a document, then the court must decide it immediately. Only in the case when the objection is in respect of the admissibility of a document, the court can take a call at the final stage and tentatively mark the document as exhibited. The word uses tentatively marked as exhibit, not finally marked as exhibit. So that means that tentatively marked exhibited document is also not a proven document. Your objection is along with that, but it will be taken care of later. So this is also a very important judgment, Hemendra Ghia's judgment. Now, while this journey, when we are talking, a very important judgment of the Supreme Court came in 2003, that is Amir Trading Company's judgment of 2003 Supreme Court. Amir Trading Company, for the first time in 2003 Supreme Court, has held that in civil litigation, in a civil trial, examination in chief need not to happen in the witness box. It is in this Amir Trading's judgment the Supreme Court said that the examination in chief can happen through affidavit. Later on, our own CPC was also amended and brought this into the statute. And another vital judgment of 2003 and succeeded by 2005 Supreme Court is Salem Advocates Association. These two judgments, both are of Salem Advocates Association, Supreme Court 2003 and Supreme Court 2005. These two judgments where the Supreme Court has held that a list of documents, when produced along with the examination in chief affidavit, needs to be proved by witness entering into witness box. Please understand, your affidavit you are filing in the court, normally affidavits are filed by affirmation. Earlier that affirmation used to happen in the court, now even notarized affirmation is allowed. But Salem Advocates Association's judgment, the Supreme Court said that when you are filing an affidavit of examination chief, along with that when you are producing documents, remember Sudhir Engineering's judgment where the Delhi High Court said this is the second stage. At the time of submitting evidence, the document of evidence, first you have filed, second evidence, this is the second stage. The Supreme Court and Salem Advocates Association, as if confirming the Delhi High Court's view, stated that when you file these documents along with the evidence, these documents must be affirmed by witness coming into the witness box and affirming every document that this is the document I'm producing, and then evidence exhibit number should be given to it. Simpliciter by filing along with the evidence is not sufficient, and the courts would not be bound to exhibit those documents. And clearly the Supreme Court said that even the second stage is not enough. That along with the affidavit you file these documents, by entering into a witness box, exhibit number is given, that is not enough. Then comes that third stage to prove each document. And please remember, if you are dealing with a company against you, we all face such cases where not only the defendants are individuals as well as company. Sometimes we make company as a defendant, then the directors, defendant number two, defendant number three. Sometimes we make a partnership firm, then partners two, three, four. I'm giving you a very vital clue. Remember very carefully. What happens is, in a criminal trial, please record it. Recording of a plea is very vital. Now what happens is, when you serve the summons, who appears to answer those summons? In the list of your accused, accused number one is company. Two, three, four are directors. You have served the summons to all accused, including the company. But who answers the summons? Does the company appear? It's always individual who appears. And who represents the company? These very directors, two, three, four. They only appear. And who records the plea? These directors, two, three, four. Please take care. Who records the plea for company? The accused number one never records the plea. And most of the times, it escapes notice of the court also. That accused number one's plea is never recorded. Two, three, four individually came and recorded the plea, not guilty. Trial begins. So as a lawyer of the complainant, take care. And if it is escaping the notice, some courts are very vigilant, some courts take care of that. But if it is not, then bring it into the notice of the court and say that these very people or one of them has to record the plea on behalf of number one as well, whoever is authorized. Because remember, if the plea is not recorded, further trial is vitiated, being irregular. How could you prove ahead without the plea? And rest of the documents which you have exhibited will not apply against one, number one. And if your claim is against number one, your whole claim collapses even after you have exhibited the document, proven the document, everything you've done. at the fag end of the trial, if there is a smart lawyer from the opposite side, he'll say, where's the plea for the number one? The company has never recorded the plea, either guilty, not guilty. So be very careful. These are minutes which you must take care of as a practicing lawyer. And that is why I'm thankful to these august gathering at the dignitaries who invited me, because this is not a law lecture of a classroom. This is practical tips of practicing lawyers, where we are discussing, we all are lawyers, and I'm not saying that I'm the one who's having all the wisdom. Even I learn from all of, most of the things from you. And maybe after this, I'm sure there must be some question answer session, and you may flummox me with your questions. Your questions may, I may not have those answers. But this is the reason the word attached to us lawyers is practice. We are never perfect. We all keep practicing the law, because law is an ocean. There's so much to know. And that is why, if you observe the current scenario of the Supreme Court, it is so inconsistent, as if the Supreme Court is also learning with an every new judgment, the earlier one is overruled. Sometimes Supreme Court said X, and then there is a review petition, and the Supreme Court says Y. First the Supreme Court said Sabrimala, everybody is allowed, then again it is challenged, and again Supreme Court is confused and says, all right, we'll reconsider Sabrimala. Recently I heard that Supreme Court is reconsidering the definition of Hindutva. Supreme Court is still not able to decide whether those four culprits of Nirbhaya case be hanged or not hanged, or when hanged. So it's all practice going on. So never be ashamed of your ignorance. We all are lawyers, we are practicing, we are learning this, we are making a dip in the ocean of the knowledge of law, and we are learning. And I'm thankful for these organizers to keep inviting me, and just Mr. Sutavne has said that he intends to invite me again. I hope you are there as this crowd. I'm so happy that it is all full and are not bored. So I just sum it up with the fact that right from 1927 Lahore's judgment till these recent judgments of Venkat Chalam Supreme Court and Bombay High Court and Hemendra Gya's judgment, the situation as on today is little settled than earlier. Now we know the distinction that admissibility of a document is different than a proving of a document. Once a document is exhibited, even then it is not considered as proved. You have every right to raise objection. Admissibility's objection can be raised even at a later stage, not immediately. But the court can decide it at a later stage, at a final stage, not immediately. But insufficiency of the stamping of a document or mode of proving has to be raised immediately. The court needs to decide it immediately. This is the settled situation. I hope some of your confusions I was able to remove and eradicate. I wish you all good luck in your practice. Thank you so much.